guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to Weekly Reads, where I talk about the books that I read in the past week and the ones that I'm reading currently. So basically, in the past week I just finished one book, and that is Shaggy Bane by Douglas Stewart, which I liked a lot. I didn't love the book, I just liked it, and I only liked it simply because of the story and the plot, because it was a very heart touching story. It was a very, very nice one. I loved the book only because of the story, but I did not like the pacing at all. The book only picks up after 20 chapters, and the point is, like, it's an easy book to DNF on some level for those who don't like slow books, and everything happens only in the last 10-12 chapters. In the first 20 chapters, things are just like mundane, or like it's like a setup for whatever has to happen in the last 10-12 chapters. So yeah, I think that's an issue that I had with the book, and that's why I did not rate it like a full-on 5. But that being said, if you really like good sad books which talk about, like, heart touching stories for that matter, emotional stories for that matter, I was just searching for the word in my head. So yeah, I mean, it's a nice book. I would say do read it. It's a good Booker shortlisted book. So yeah, that's that. Now let's get to the books that I'm reading currently. So the first book that I'm reading currently is the last book in my Booker shortlist. I was expecting to finish this last week, but I could not. I just have like a few, I think I was like 100 pages left. I'll be finishing it this week anyhow. And this is Real Life by Brandon Taylor, as you can see. And there's a lot of, I don't know, what do you call it? Flagging? Is that called flagging? Highlighting? Yeah, so there are a lot of notes in the book as well. So I love this book so far. This is a very well-paced book. Like, this is kind of the opposite of Shaggy Bane currently. It's a nice book. And I'm kind of reaching the climax because it's the last 100 pages and cannot wait to finish this. So that's that. The next book that I'm reading currently is The next book that I'm reading currently is Rebel Sultans by Manu S. Pillai. So basically, for those of you who don't know, this is Indian historical non-fiction, and it talks about the Deccan region of India, and it was kind of a Diwali gift, so thank you. And the point is that this is a brilliant, lovely, thoroughly researched book. Okay, that's like the gist of the book. Whenever we talk about the Deccan region of India, we only think about Shivaji, or we only think about Aurangzeb, or, you know, like the whole Maratha Mughal conflict in Indian history during the medieval period. But Indian history is kind of more convoluted or complex than these simple things that we read in our textbooks, and this one does tend to cover it very well. So I'm kind of like, I don't know, maybe I'm done with, like, I just like started this yesterday, so I'm kind of done with like 26 pages, 30 pages of the book. But I think the only thing to note, if you want to read this, would be, one, you need to like history, and two, this is written like a history textbook. So if you really liked history in school, or if you really like informative books about Indian history, then this is a book that you should pick up. I really like this book a lot. Especially I like this because you'll see why I like this. So this is set in the 1500s, the Deccan Plateau in India. So this is set in 1500s. And the next book that I'm reading is set in the 1500s in England, and that is Bring Up the Bodies by Hilary Mantel, which is the second book in the Wolf Hall trilogy. The thing is that I'm passively reading this again, like I'm not reading this full-fledged, but the interesting point is that I'm reading Bring Up the Bodies and Rebel Sultans kind of at the same time. So this is giving me more insight about 1500s India, and this is giving me more insight about 1500s England. So this book does then travel to, you know, 1600s and stuff as well, while I think Wolf Hall does not do that, because Wolf Hall just talks about Henry VIII and, you know, Thomas Cromwell and their lives. But this one kind of covers the whole Deccan history and all the, wars and the battles that have happened in medieval India. in the Deccan region. So that's that. So that being said, the final book that I'm reading currently is Art Matters by Neil Gaiman. This is actually a very short read that I'm going to finish it anyway in the next 2 days. It talks about, it's a non-fiction book by the way, and Neil Gaiman talks about why should people read and why is fiction so important in today's world. And I really like it so far. I actually started the audiobook just today and it's just like a 1 hour audiobook, so I'll finish it anyway. So it's very interesting. I like Neil Gaiman as an author, but I'm not like a huge fan of Neil Gaiman. I just like Neil Gaiman. You understand the difference, right? But then I really like his thoughts on books and the thoughts that he's mentioned in this particular book. So yeah, that's that. So yes, that's it. That's what I'm reading currently. And November is going to be a very busy month. Diwali is coming up. Happy Diwali in advance to everybody. And yeah, that's that. That's it for my weekly reads. Okay, thank you. I'll see you next time on my Sunday upload. Bye.